It measures 16.5 inches by 13.5 inches and sits 5.5 inches tall. It has a semi-transparent acrylic dust cover that sits atop a wooden plinth with a glossy walnut wood grain finish. While marketed as an entry-level model, its looks are decidedly high-end. The platter is cast aluminum and belt-driven, and the unit comes with a thick rubber slip mat and AT95E phono cartridge. There is a little bit of setup involved out of the box, like installing the platter, counterweight, and balancing the tone arm, but the process is relatively straightforward if you follow the manual. If all of this sounds intimidating, Fluence has a few helpful videos on their product page to help you get started. The turntable controls are straightforward. In fact, there's only one knob. At the front left-hand corner is a selector dial that lets you choose your record speed of 33 and a third or 45 revolutions per minute. On the back of the unit is where you'll find your hookups for audio input, ground post, phono line selector, auto stop setting, and power port. Although the unit has a built-in preamp, you can elect to use an external one, in which case you'll need to hook up the ground post and select the phono setting. The auto stop setting is nice because it starts spinning the platter only when the tone arm is positioned above the platter, and it stops spinning the platter after it's played the last track on the record. The unit does come with an adapter and audio cable with ground cable, but you'll have to provide your own amplifier and speakers. I'm using this unit with Fluence's Signature Series bookshelf speakers, and I was pretty impressed with the sound. Records play back smoothly with excellent clarity. There's typically little distortion, bright trebles, and full bass across genres. Keep in mind results may vary depending on your preamp, amp, and speaker setup, as well as the condition of your records and if you decide to change the phono cartridge. Now there are cheaper turntables out there, and Fluence even makes a slightly less expensive one, the RT80, for just $200. On the flip side, there are much more expensive ones that only highly attuned ears would pick up the differences in sound quality. But even if you are a seasoned vinyl junkie, I think you'll be able to appreciate the depth and quality that the RT81 provides. I hope you enjoyed this review. You can ask me any questions in the comments. I'll put a link to the product in the description below. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and join me next time.